Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Arcoin, myself Arnob Kundu. Today I will discuss some problem in Java language. So go to the computer screen. Hello friends, today I will discuss a topic, demonstrate in Java language, right? So actually at first we should know there are two types of threads. One is your user thread and another is your daemon thread, right? The daemon thread is a service provider thread, okay? It provides services to the user thread, okay? Its life depends on the user threads. That is, when all the user threads dies, JVM terminates this thread automatically, right? It provides services to the user threads for background supporting tasks, okay? It has no role in life to serve user threads, okay? Its life depends on user threads, okay? It is a low priority thread, right? Now, one question should arise, why JVM terminates the daemon thread if there is no user thread remaining? Because the sole purpose of the daemon thread is that it provides services to the user thread for background supporting task. If there is no user thread, why should JVM keep running this thread, right? That is why JVM terminates the daemon thread if there is no user thread, okay? Now I talk about another part, methods of daemon thread. There is a two methods is there. One method is set daemon, another method is daemon. So using these two methods, we make a thread as daemon thread, right? So go to the Java IDE. I will provide an example of daemon thread, okay? Okay friends, so now I write the program for daemon thread is concerned in Java language. So at first I write a class, suppose write class, and the class name is my thread, okay? And I just extends the thread class, okay? And provide the brace open, brace close. And within that class, at first we provide the method public void run, okay? And within that, we are providing two statements. At first, we write system.out.println, and within braces, just write within double quote name equal, and after just write plus and write here thread dot and just write current thread method, okay? And after just write dot and just write another method get name, right? And after that just end it with semicolon. And similar way we are writing another system dot out dot println and also provide this double quote, and now just write here daemon equal, and same way provide plus and write here thread dot, same way write current thread method, and after put dot, and now here write another method is daemon, okay, and put a semicolon. Clear? And after what, this is the end of your run method, and now provide here the main method. So just write public static void main and provide as argument string args, okay, string array, okay. After what, here we provide the statement. Now the statement is that we are instantiate my thread class. So just write my thread t1 equal, just write new, and after we write my thread, okay. This is the instantiate of my thread class, okay. And similar manner we also instantiate again my thread class, just write t2 and provide equal new, just write my thread. Clear? And close it and put a semicolon. Now what happened? Now I set t1 thread as a daemon. So just write t1 dot set daemon and put the argument as true. Means now the t1 thread is just set as a daemon thread. Okay, now I just start these two thread. Just write t1 dot start and just write t2 dot start. Okay, so here these are two methods, is there get name and is daemon. Get name provides the name of the thread and is daemon provide the state of the thread. If the thread is daemon, it provides true. If the thread is not daemon, it provides false. Okay, so after that we just run that particular Java file. So just go to the run and go to the run option and save it, and after what, just see as a output we get name thread 0 means t1 dot start, it's assigned as a thread 0, so that's why it's a get name is thread 0. And after is daemon is a true. Why? Because we already set this t1 thread as a daemon because it's a true. After t2 dot start, its name is thread 1, so get name is provide its name as thread 1, but is daemon just provide as output false because t2 thread never set as true as a daemon thread, right? So in that way we can write our daemon thread program in Java, right? One thing should be noted, if we want to make a user thread as daemon, it must not be started, otherwise it will throw illegal thread state exception, right?
I hope that you have understood today's topic. For more videos, keep watching my channel Technical Arcoin. Thank you and bye bye.